Good morning and welcome to our 11 o'clock service here at St. John's. This is our second Sunday in Advent, and today we have the Light Before Christmas presented by our children and youth. Just a few announcements. If you would like to know more about St. John's and about being a United Methodist, we continue our Getting to Know St. John series next week with who we are as United Methodists, a little history of the United Methodist Church with Dr. Tim. Also, you can still reserve a poinsettia for the beautification of the gym or the sanctuary. The poinsettias that will be here in the sanctuary can be picked up following the 11 o'clock service on Christmas Eve. So take an opportunity to remember a loved one in that way. Also, the Advent study continues this week, Wednesday night at 6 o'clock, and also on Thursday morning at 10 a.m. So please join us for that. Sunny Monday meets tomorrow. We invite all of the retirees to come at 10:30 in Ward Hall. The Joyful Sounds Bell Choir will be there to present a program of Christmas music. It'll be lots of fun, so please come. Also, please record your presence on the friendship pad. They're located near the center aisle, and pass those down. Now, let our worship service begin. Thank you.
Thank you. to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem, see that baby, going to Bethlehem, see that child, going to Bethlehem, see that baby, going to Bethlehem, gonna take a walk.
Going to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem,
going to Bethlehem, see that baby, going to Bethlehem, see that child, going to Bethlehem, see that baby, going to Bethlehem, gonna take a walk.
Going to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem.
Look over yonder and see the wise men on a journey they travel afar. Look over yonder and see the wise men led to Bethlehem by a star. Going to Bethlehem, see that baby, going to Bethlehem, see that child, going to Bethlehem, see that baby, going to Bethlehem, gonna take a walk.
Going to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem.
Look over yonder and see the shepherds watching over their flocks by night. Look over yonder and see the shepherds by the light of a star so bright. Going to Bethlehem, see that baby, going to Bethlehem, see that child, going to Bethlehem, see that baby, going to Bethlehem, gonna take a walk.
Going to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem. I'm gonna sing
heavenly melodies when I see that child.
I'm gonna
sing heavenly melodies when I see that child.
I'm gonna shout,
shout, shout, hallelujah when I see that child.
I'm gonna shout,
shout, shout, hallelujah when I see that child. Oh, going to Bethlehem, see that baby, going to Bethlehem, see that child. Going to Bethlehem, see that baby, going to Bethlehem, gonna take a walk.
Going to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem.
Look over yonder and see the angels from the heavens they come to earth. Look over yonder and see the angels singing praise of a baby's birth. Going to Bethlehem, see that baby, going to Bethlehem, see that child. Going to Bethlehem, see that baby, going to Bethlehem, gonna take a going to Bethlehem, 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 see that baby, going to Bethlehem, see that child, going to Bethlehem, see that baby, going to Bethlehem, gonna take a walk.
Going to Bethlehem,
going to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem, to see that going to Bethlehem, going to Bethlehem.
Once in royal David's city stood a lowly cattle shed, where a mother laid her baby in a manger for his bed. Mary, loving mother mild, Jesus Christ, her little child.
Amen. Okay, kids, let's start this rehearsal. We've got a lot to do for the Advent program tonight.
I am so excited about this program. Aren't you all?
Yeah!
My grandma's coming all the way from Colombia, so this better be good.
Trust me, it will.
I hope my baby brother doesn't cry all the way through this program tonight.
Oh, hey, kids. I'm sorry to interrupt your practice, but I want everything to look extra wonderful for the play tonight.
Why did you put those extra candles in the windows?
The extra candles, well, the preacher told me to do it, and you know how he is.
Oh, yeah!
If it's okay with you, we'll just keep rehearsing now.
Hey, does anyone here know about the special ornaments on the tree?
They're called Christmas.
Now, Clayton.
Back when we were your age and learned all about them. A chrismon is a monogram for Christ. All these designs are symbols for Christ and have passed down for many years. They remind us that Christmas is all about God's gift to the world, Jesus. Chrismons are made in white, symbolizing the Lord's purity, in gold, symbolizing his majesty and glory. The white lights on the tree symbolize Christ as the light of the world. Some of you are part of making these chrismons. Do you remember what they stand for?
This one's a circle, since it's a figure without beginning or ending, symbolizing eternity and our eternal life with God.
This one is the symbol Chiro and is the oldest monogram for Christ. It was commonly used in the early church. Just think, everybody, it's been around for a very long time. The crown symbolizes the kingship of our Lord and his victory over sin and death.
There are many different depictions of crosses, and each one has a special significance. This is a Greek cross, in which all four arms are of equal length. This is a Latin cross. It is the most commonly used form of crosses among Christians. It is believed to be the cross in which our Lord was crucified.
This is a cross of triumph, which is a Latin cross on the globe. It signifies the conquest of the world by Christianity and God's dominion over the world. This is a Celtic cross with a circle around the center symbolizing eternity.
I'm holding an anchor cross, which is a cross for hope. The cross rises out of a crescent moon, which is a symbol for Mary.
Hey guys, I'm pretty sure there's a cross missing. That's a left cross. My dad taught it to me in boxing. Right, Pops?
And that brings us to the next symbol, the dove. Gavin?
The dove is a sign of the Holy Spirit, and the butterfly is a sign of resurrection.
Well, I've got a couple more. My wife Mabel and I, we made some together years ago, and one is a fish. You know, long ago in Jesus' day, his first followers would make a sign using a stick, scratching in the dirt, and they would use the sign of a fish because the initials for the word fish spells ichthus, which is the word fish, but ichthus stands for Jesus Christ, God's Son, our Savior. And so if they met someone else, they would draw their sign in the dirt, and if the other person was a Christian, then they would draw a sign of a fish in the dirt. And then the other one that we made is called the Latin cross. And the Latin cross has got a shepherd's crook at the top. It goes in an X with a P. And it stands for the first letters of the word Christ. It also has a triangle in it that reminds us that we believe in God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And then it's got the monogram M for Mary because of the Virgin Mary and how much she played a role in the first Christmas.
Okay, let's finish putting on the ornaments and light up the tree. Hopefully that'll get us in the mood to sing.
Thank you.
Place, you're just a little bit early. It doesn't start for another hour. But do you all like to sing? You can come sing in the youth choir. We've got some extra music.
I only sing one note.
Yeah, the wrong one.
Okay, well, you can help with the little kids.
We love to sing. We come from a small town. We sing in our church every Christmas. We're the only kids at our church, actually.
Because we are not used to such a big place.
We may be big, but we're just like family. We have such a great time every Christmas. There's something for everyone. Join us.
Now let us invite our ushers forward to come receive our tithes and offerings.
Set thy people free. From our fears and sins release us. Let us find our rest in thee.
As for strength and consolation, hope of all the earth thou art. Dear desire of every nation, joy of every longing heart. Born to save, born to heal, come, Lord, Savior, come. While we pray, come, Savior, come. Hope of all, heaven and earth, come, Jesus, come. Jesus Christ.
Let us now sing "O Little Town of Bethlehem" on page 230 of your hymnals.
Thank you.
Advent symbols, they remind us to get ready for Jesus' first coming as we commemorate his birth and as we prepare ourselves for his second coming. The symbols of Christmas season, of Advent season, inspire us. We have evergreens in our homes and evergreens in the church that remind us that new life, even in the midst of bleak midwinter, is possible through Jesus Christ. We have wreaths of green and of holly, reminding us that eternal life never ends as we look at that circle. We think of the red and green, which comes from the holly, which is all about us and stays green throughout the year in all sorts of climates. It reminds us of Jesus, the green of life, and Jesus bringing eternal life. It reminds us through the red of Jesus' sacrifice. And so we have all sorts of colors, like the ornaments and chrismons on trees, to help reflect the light, even as we reflect Jesus' light unto the world. We have so many special things about this season, including music, of course. Music is so much a part of Christmas season, even of Advent, as a way for us to feel what the incarnation, what Jesus coming in the flesh, really means. It soothes us and inspires us. It lifts us to heights beyond our mundane or sorrowful world. We have the lights even of the Advent candle, the Advent set in that wreath, round, eternal. The first candle, of course, is the candle of hope, the candle of waiting. It's a purple candle. The candle for today is the candle of peace, another purple candle. And then the third candle is the pink candle. The pink candle reminds us of joy, just as these children and their singing and these youth remind us of their joy. That pink candle is often called the candle for Gaudet Sunday. Gaudet is an old French word from which we receive that word joy. And some of us sometimes think of something that's a little bit beyond decorum, maybe perhaps even tacky, as something that's gaudy. But truly, gaudy is a good word. Gaudet means joy. So on the third Sunday, next Sunday, when our choir is singing their cantata, will be a time for us to lift those songs that remind us so much of Christmas and its joy. And then the fourth candle, another purple candle, is a candle that reminds us of God's love and coming to earth through his son, Jesus Christ. And then on Christmas Eve, of course, we'll light the white candle, which represents the Christ child and his purity and holiness coming to be with us. So that candelabra with those four candles represent the 4,000 years that God's people waited for Jesus, the Messiah, to be born. It's one of our ways of telling time. All of these symbols, from candles, from songs, from lights to evergreens, from holly, and all of the other symbols, remind us of Jesus' coming. But there's one symbol, as I think of today's candle. Remember, today is the candle of peace. Peace, isn't it an interesting word? You can't really shout out the word peace. It's something that's meant to be whispered. Peace. Peace. I'm reminded of that as I read from Isaiah's prophecy about Jesus. In Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6, it says, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." Prince of Peace. "And of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end." There will be no end. 100 years ago, at this very time of year, during Advent season, just before Christmas, in the midst of World War I, 100 years ago, right now, there were Allied soldiers who were fighting German soldiers and their cohorts. And someone on the German side started singing Stille Nacht, Silent Night. And the English troops and their allies started singing in English, Silent Night. holy night, about peace. And then some of those soldiers started fraternizing with one another. They laid down their guns. And as a matter of fact, one of the things that they did was they shared gifts. And this is actually one of those boxes that was shared. It was sent by the royal family of England. George V's daughter, Princess Mary, has her likeness. And I'm sure 17-year-old Princess was quite a morale boost for those soldiers in the trenches. And around it, it has her initials, Mary. And it has Christmas 1914 down at the bottom. And around it, the flags and the names of all the Allied countries. And of course, it included all sorts of candies and goodies. They're all gone now. And a Christmas card from Princess Mary. This box reminds me, as enemies became friends, as peace came to those trenches filled with warfare and mud and all of the disasters that come from fighting, peace was brought. It was given, just as we've been given all these symbols. Today we have peace, and we pray for peace, and we pray to make peace. And we thank you for the symbols that these children and youth offer to us, these symbols to inspire us to bring peace on earth. Amen.
Flame will be dying soon. The candles of Advent remind us that God is the creator of light. The Bible says that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. In the gentle warmth of these tiny flames, we find comfort and assurance. We gather in their glow, seeking hope, peace, joy, and love. When we light the candles, we prepare our hearts for the coming of Jesus, the light of the world.
Advent is the candle of hope. As people from long ago looked forward to the birth of Jesus, we also wait for the coming of the Lord. May this candle help us to recall that even in the darkest shadows, we are all God's children of light.
Sings a child. shines like a flower in the smoke. Hope helps warm your heart when nights are cold. Hope dries the falling tear. Hope calms our doubts and fears. Hope is like a flower in the snow.
Hope is like a flower. Hope is like a love song. Hope is like a candle in the night.
The second candle of Advent is the candle of peace. As we light this special candle, we remember that peace is possible. God promises that a day is coming when the wolf and the lamb will live together and the lion and the calf will not be enemies. On that glorious day, Jesus will come to lead us as the gentle shepherd and the Prince of Peace.
Thank you.
The third candle of Advent is the candle of joy. Isaiah the prophet delighted in God's promises when he wrote, "The people in darkness have seen a great light, and those living in shadows have seen a new dawn."
Mary rejoiced to learn that she would be the mother of Jesus. Her heart overflowed with worship and thanksgiving. In her happiness, Mary sang these words, "My heart praises the Lord. My soul is glad because of this great thing the mighty God has done for me."
With each passing day, the time grows shorter until we see the Lord. Because of this good news, we gather together and share our songs of faith. With exceeding great joy, we lift our voices in celebration.
The candle of Advent is the candle of love. Of all God's blessings, nothing is more precious than love. As we light the love candle, we recall that God loved the world so much that he sent us Jesus. And if we trust in him, we will live forever. This is the heart of God. This is the reason we sing.
Jesus is coming soon.
light the Christ candle to celebrate the birth of Jesus. It will be a glorious time in which we have waited and prepared. God's perfect light will shine in our darkness, and even in the deepest shadows will never overcome it.
Let us then prepare our hearts so every heart may be a shining candle lifted high for all to see, and may its flame of holy light be the spark that brings hope, peace, joy, and love into our world.
Come, Lord Jesus, come.
Of all the symbols of Christmas, Jesus said about children, of such is the kingdom of heaven. And I think we've seen one of his greatest symbols, not only in the Christ child, but in all these children. And so let's thank them for all that they've given us today. They give us peace. They give us peace. I don't know if any of you have the name Irene. It stands for peace. It's the Greek word Irene, peace. Well, if you've got that name, we don't sing Goodnight Irene, thanks to you guys. For the rest of Advent and for Christmas, we say, welcome to peace through Jesus the Christ. Oh.
Excuse me, we were looking for the Christmas program at St. John's, but it seems as though we've missed it.
Oh, you haven't missed it. Just listen, 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 and look at these faces.
We're sorry you missed it, but you can come back on Christmas Eve. We've got a beautiful service then.
These people are just great. We just moved to Aiken, and we've already found our new church family.
Meanwhile, we're having punch and cookies down at Ward Hall. Please be our guest tonight and get to know some of the people in the church.
Would everyone join and sing us in hymn number 218, It Came Upon the Midnight Clear?
Thank you.
once again, thanks to these adult leaders and thanks to these youth and children for their gift to us this year. May we bring them a gift as well as we bring peace into the world through Jesus Christ our Lord. And now may the peace that passes all understanding guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.